Good day and welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about work energy theorem. We'll talk about work done, few types of energy, and the conservation of energy. First, let's see the definition of work. It is the scalar product of the force applied and the displacement of the object. Remember that scalar product produces a scalar quantity, hence work is a scalar. As we have discussed in the first chapter, magnitude of work also depends on the angle between the force and the displacement. So the formula is given as the work is equal to Fs cos theta. Next, we go through the energy which you have learned in SPM. First is the gravitational potential energy. From the formula of work done that if we move up an object at a distance of h with constant velocity, force applied will be equal to the weight of the object, F equal to mg. Hence, we would have the gravitational potential energy as mgh. Second is the kinetic energy. We also start from the formula of F is equal to Fs, where F is equal to ma. From the linear motion equations, v squared equal to u squared plus 2as, we can do the substitution here to obtain the kinetic energy as half m multiplied v squared minus u squared. Third is the elastic potential energy, which is related to the spring. We have the word to compress or to extend the spring is the integral of the force applied with respect to the extension of the spring. Here we have the formula of elastic potential energy is equal to half kx squared, or also can be expressed as half fx. So in conclusion, there's one thing you can take note is about the work energy theorem, which is the main topic of this video. The work is done and cause increase in the mechanical energy of the system, which includes those three types of energy mentioned just now. If there is change in height or position in the gravity field, we have change in gravitational potential energy. If there is change in velocity of object, there is change in kinetic energy. And if there is extension or compression of spring, we have change in elastic potential energy. Remember about the principle of conservation of energy, that energy can be neither created nor destroyed, but it can be converted into another form. Let's see one example from trial paper SMK YU HUA in 2021. Here we have the block mass of 2 kg is rest on the rough plane as shown in the diagram. There is 20 N force acts on the object to move it out the plane. Coefficient of kinetic friction is given as 0.2. Refer back to our previous discussion on the friction. We need to identify the reaction force to calculate the friction force. Before that, let's draw a free body diagram. We have the 20 N force which is 30 degrees to the inclined plane. Here I suggest to solve this question in these two components, that is parallel and perpendicular to the plane surface. Next is the friction force, which is opposite to the motion of object. And then is the weight of the object, which is always downward. So split it into that two components also. Lastly is the reaction force, which is always normal to the contact surface. Now we can start to solve this question. We start from the perpendicular component where the object is assumed always stay on the plane surface. So we have the forces in equilibrium. Here we have the reaction force plus the perpendicular component of 20 N equal to mg cos 15. Solving this will give us the reaction force is equal to 8.95 N. Next, we shall solve parallel components. Object is expected moving out the plane. We take the parallel component of 20 N force minus the friction and also minus mg sin 15. We have a net force of 10.46 N. Hence, we can conclude the object is moving up the plane with constant acceleration. Apply the formula F equal to ma, we can calculate it is equal to 5.23 meters per second squared. So now, let's see what happened at the time of 3 seconds. You can apply the linear equation formula to get the information of the motion. First is the V equal to U plus AT, and you can obtain the velocity at 3 seconds is 15.69 meters per second. Then, you also can apply the formula S equal to UT plus half AT squared, and you can obtain the distance travel is 23.54 meters, which is in the direction in parallel with the inclined surface. So now, let's do some discussion about the work. Observe the solution of parallel components. We have the friction force equal to mu r and the gravitational force mg sin 15. When the 20 N force is applied, we have work done against the friction, which can be formulated as mu r multiplied displacement, 23.54 meters, and the work is equal to 42.1 N. Then, we have the work done against the gravity, so put into the formula of W equal to Fs, the work here is equal to 119.5 N. After that, we have the net force of 10.46 N, we have the net work done of 246.2 N. So why do I mention each of these work in a specific way? Based on work energy theorem, The work done will cause increase in mechanical energy. The first work done, which is against the friction, will be converted to the heat energy. You can try to rub your own hand and you may feel some warmness which reflect there is heat energy when the surface is rubbing. Second work done is against the gravity, so there's increase in gravitational potential energy. Here you can apply the formula of W equal to mgh. We can obtain the height of the object from the initial position is 6.09 meter. Lastly, the net work done on the object will be reflected into the increase in kinetic energy. The object is rest initially. We have the equations of W equal to half mv squared, and we can obtain the final velocity at the time of 3 seconds is 15.69 meter per second, which is aligned with the answer obtained just now. In conclusion, work done on the system can increase the mechanical energy, and work also has the same unit as energy, which is in joule. We shall look one more example from past year in 2015. A block of mass 65 g is placed at 8 cm above the top end of a spring. Based on conservation of energy, the block on top shall have gravitational potential energy, which will be converted when it is released. When the object is falling, until the time just before the spring is compressed, the loss in gravitational potential energy is converted into the kinetic energy of object. Apply the energy conservation, where mgh is equal to half mv squared. We can obtain the velocity of object before it starts to compress the spring is equal to 1.25 meter per second. Then, we're going to discuss the case where the spring is compressed until a maximum extension. You can imagine that the object will start to decelerate, hence the kinetic energy is converted into the elastic potential energy in the spring. In addition, there is also further reduced in gravitational potential energy since the object is still falling. So here we have decrease in both gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy is equal to the increase in elastic potential energy. The extension of spring x is also the reduce in the height of object. So apply the energy conservation that mgx plus half mv squared is equal to half kx squared, or you can also use the formula of mg multiply h plus x on the left hand side of the equations. Solving these quadratic equations will give you the compression of the spring is equal to 0.05 meter. So this is the example of energy conservation. Just observe the case carefully and identify the energy changes will give you some ideas to solve similar questions. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you still have any questions, leave it in the comment section below. Also, click the like and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.